excellent is your name. How excellent is your name.
King of kings is his name, the Lord of lords is his name. He is the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Savior of the world. Before we can know how big this king is, we must know what the kingdom is. If you look at the scriptures from 1 Corinthians 4 verse 20, 1 Corinthians 4 verse 20 says, the kingdom of God is not a matter of talk but of power. 1 Corinthians 4 verse 20. It therefore behold that the kingdom of God is a very powerful kingdom. The word kingdom is a compound word formed from king and domain. The king is God, and the domain or the territory of this king is heaven. The book of Psalms, Psalm 95 verse 3 says, for the Lord is the great God and the great king above all gods. A kingdom is a territory where a king reigns or rules. When we talk of the kingdom of God, we are talking about the kingdom of heaven. The book of Psalms 103 verse 19 says, the Lord has established his throne in heaven. His kingdom rules over all. There are three kingdoms in the universe. Three kingdoms that exist in this universe. The first is the kingdom of God that is located in heaven. The second is the kingdom of Satan that is located in the air. That's why it is called the prince of the air. The third is the kingdom of man which is located in the earth. We know from the words of Jesus in Luke 11 verse 18 that Satan has a kingdom. Because Jesus said in Luke 11 verse 18, that if Satan also is divided against himself, how will his kingdom stand? This shows that Satan has a kingdom. We also know that there exists a kingdom of the world. In Luke 4 verse 5, during the temptation of Jesus by Satan, Luke 4 verse 5, then the devil, talking with him, take him to a high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment. Then the devil, taking him up on a high mountain, showed him all the kingdom of the world in a moment. That shows that there's a kingdom of the world. And then Jesus answered, he said, my kingdom is not of this world. That is the first kingdom we're talking about, the kingdom of heaven. Says, if my kingdom were of this world, my servants would, so I should not be delivered to the Jews. But now my kingdom is not from here. Also in Luke 17, verses 20 to 21, Jesus said, now when he was asked by the Pharisees where the kingdom of God will come, he answered and said, the kingdom of God does not come with physical observation, nor they say, see here or see there, for indeed the kingdom of God is within you. What Jesus is saying in this place is that the kingdom of God is not a physical kingdom, it's a spiritual kingdom. Granted, heaven is a physical location, but it is a spiritual dwelling place. There's a physical heaven, a physical hell. There are specific physical locations in the universe. But Jesus is explaining that the kingdom of God is spiritual and cannot be seen with ordinary eyes, but that the kingdom of God lives within us. On the other hand, the kingdom of the world is physical. The two spiritual kingdoms exert influence and rule over the weaker physical kingdom. The kingdom of Satan and the kingdom of God, they are both spiritual kingdoms. They exert influence and rule over the kingdom of man, which is physical. When God reigns on the earth, there is joy. This is in Psalm 97 verse 1. The Lord reigns, let the earth rejoice, let the multitude of Israel be glad. The kingdom of God is not in eating and drinking, but in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. We know the song of Ron Connolly that says, righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. That is the kingdom of God. Again, righteousness,
is joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God.
You want to be a part of the kingdom.
Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom?
You want to be a part of the kingdom. Come on, everybody.
There is.
So we know that the kingdom of God is not in eating and drinking, but in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. When the life of man is governed by the kingdom of God, the man will have peace, joy, and righteousness. But the kingdom of Satan operates in a life, the heart of a man. When the kingdom of Satan operates in a life, the heart and the life of that man will produce evidence of lies, hatred, unforgiveness, fornication, and adultery. The devil comes to steal and to destroy. John 10:10. The kingdom of Satan comes to bring you in sickness, sin, suffering, and death. In the Gospel of Mark, chapter 5, we see how the devil possessed the madman of Gadarene and destroyed his life before Jesus intervened. Just as God Almighty will intervene in the life of someone that is listening to this message today,
amen,
right now, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It doesn't care, it doesn't matter how long the devil has been holding you bound. Even
yes,
that daughter of Zion that was there for 18 years, bent over. So
yes,
said, is it not lawful that this daughter of Zion be loosed on the Sabbath day, whom the Satan has bound all these 18 years? So you will be loosed, you woman listening to this message right now. Whatever the bondage, whatever the devil has brought against you, that you will be loosed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beloved, I have good news for you. The kingdom of God can come to correct and destroy whatever the devil has done in your life. The kingdom of God operates with great power. Hebrews 12:29. For God is a consuming fire. The kingdom of God goes with the fire. It announces the presence of God. The kingdom of God can heal and deliver. Jesus said in Luke 11 verse 20, but I cast out demons with the finger of God. Surely the kingdom of God has come unto you. The kingdom of God is powerful. Cast out demons and destroy evil works. For this reason, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Now we see the kingdom of God is the powerful, overwhelming kingdom. The king in this kingdom is Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom it has pleased the Lord to put everything in his care. The Creator, the Father, God Almighty, has put everything in the hands of his Son, the Lord Jesus. The resurrected Jesus, the glorified Jesus, rules over the kingdom of heaven. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. He is the King of that kingdom. And every child of God, every believer in the Lord Jesus Christ is a member of that kingdom. He's a king in that kingdom. For the word of God says, we are kings and priests unto our Lord. So you are a king in the kingdom of God if you are a believer. How can you become a member of this kingdom? How can you become a member of this kingdom? In Colossians 1 verse 13, Revelations 1 verses 5, 6, and 9, 1 Corinthians 1 verse 28, we see how you can become a member of the kingdom of God. We also told that Peter, Apostle Peter, has the keys of this kingdom. In Matthew 16 verse 19, God uses to announce that Christ's reign is sufficient for us. Christ's reign in our life is sufficient evidence that we are members of the kingdom of God. In this kingdom of God, Colossians 1 verse 18 says clearly that Christ is the king. So now we know the king, we know the kingdom, and we know that to come into the kingdom, all we need to do is to surrender our life to Jesus. Then we become his children, then we become members of the kingdom. They will become kings and priests unto him, our God. Those that are born again are in the kingdom of God. John 3, verses 3 to 5 says clearly that we must be born again. Those that are born again are those that are in the kingdom.